हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू दी मैथ्स क्लास एंड आई एम जगदीश पांडे। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू अबाउट दी अलजेब्रा ऑफ मैट्रिसेस। अलजेब्रा मीन्स वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट एडिशन, सब्ट्रैक्शन एंड मल्टीप्लिकेशन। लेट्स सी एडिशन और सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ मैट्रिसेस। स्टूडेंट्स, फर्स्ट वी नीड टू लर्न अबाउट द कंडीशन व्हेन एडिशन और सब्ट्रैक्शन इज अ पॉसिबल। The addition or subtraction is a possible only when both the matrices are of same order. For different order matrix, addition and subtraction does not exist. And while adding, we add the corresponding elements. That we'll learn from this example. Here the matrix A with order 2 by 3, the matrix B also with order 2 by 3. And if you see, while adding this to matrices, we add the corresponding elements. Corresponding elements means the elements at the first row first column is going to add with the element at the first row first column of second matrix. That in matrix A, if you see, the 2 is at the first row first column. In matrix B, 6 is at the first row first column, that I have circled with the blue color, and they are going to add. Same way, 11, which is at the position of 1 2, means first row second column, that is going to add with -1, which is at the first row second column. And similarly, 5 is going to add with 2, 4 is going to add with 5, -3 is going to add with 2, and -1 is going to add with 70. That's why the final result A plus B, that if you see 2 plus 6, 8, 11 minus 1, 10, 5 plus 2, 7, 4 plus 5, 9, -3 plus 2, -1, and -1 plus 17, 16. Similarly, see the subtraction. While subtracting also, we subtract the corresponding elements. Instead of adding, we subtract. Means 2 is going to subtract with 6, 11 is going to subtract with -1, 5 is going to subtract with 2, 4 with 5, -3 with 2, and -1 with 17. But again, as I am saying, addition and subtraction possible only for same order, not for different. So 2 minus 6, that is -4, 11 minus of -1, 12, 5 minus 2, 3, 4 minus 5, -1, -3 minus 2, that is -5, and -1 minus 17, that is -18. So this way the subtraction is there. Now next concept, that is the multiplication of scalar to a matrix. Multiplication of scalar means that is a multiplication of constant. Scalar means the constant number, real number that we multiply with a matrix. So while multiplying a constant with a matrix, we multiply that constant or that scalar to all the elements of matrix. For example, let's see here the matrix A of order 3 by 3, which have 9 elements, 1, 2, 4, 0, 8, -1, 5, 7, 3. And if I want to find 3A, so just I'm going to multiply 3 with all the elements. That's why the resultant matrix, that if you see, so 3 into 1, 3 into 2, 3 into 4, 3 into 0, 3 into 8, 3 into -1, and so on, and therefore the result is 3, 6, 12, 0, 24, -3, 15, 21, and 9. Now next one, this is a very important concept, multiplication of matrices, and this condition that we need to understand thoroughly, ki when the multiplication is going to exist. The multiplication between two matrix is a possible only that if you see here, I have underlined and colored with a pink color, when the number of column in first matrix is equal to number of rows in the second matrix. Means if A is a matrix of order m by p, means m rows p columns, so then B should be the order of matrix p rows and n columns. That first ka column, that should be equal to the second ka row. Then only matrix multiplication is possible. That I am explaining you here by some example also. I have taken four matrices A with 1 3 7, which has a order 1 by 3, 1 row 3 columns. B is a 2 by 2, 2 rows 2 columns. C with 3 by 1, means 3 rows 1 column. D with 3 by 2, 3 rows and 2 columns. So if you see here that A into B does not exist. Means A into B is not possible. Why? Because number of columns in A, if you count, that is a 3. But number of rows in B is, that is 2. So that is not equal. That's why matrix multiplication is not possible. Same way, B into C will not exist because number of column in B is a 2 and number of rows in C, that is a 3. That's why again B and C multiplication is not possible. Similarly, if I'm asking about AC, so AC is going to exist because number of column in A is a 3 and number of rows in C is 3. That will see how the multiplication is going to be possible. Similarly, A into D is possible because number of column in A is a 3 and number of rows in D is a 3. So first thing, students, that we need to be very clear ki multiplication is possible only if the number of column in first, that should be equal to number of rows in second. Then only we are going to multiply, otherwise we'll say the matrix multiplication is not possible. Now let's see how we multiply. And for multiplication, I am considering one real life example, so you will understand in a better way. To understand matrix multiplication, let's consider one data that cost of one pencil is 5 rupees, cost of one pen is 10 rupees, Ram buys 2 pencil and 7 pen, whereas Mohan buys 4 pencil and 3 pens. If I ask you ki what are the exponential of Ram and Mohan, so easily you can find without matrix also. But if you remember in my first video, I told you ki matrix is the representation of data in tabular form. Here the same data first I am writing in a tabular form, that if you see the matrix A that I am representing by 5 and 10, where the cost of one pencil is a 5, cost of one pen is that is going to be 10, not pencil, and B that it is representing the Ram and Mohan's, that they have buys 2 pencil and 7 pen, whereas Mohan buys 4 pencil and 3 pens. So instead of that, 7 pen, here it is going to be 1 pen, not 7. And when we are multiplying here, so that if you see while multiplying, A is going to multiply with B in such way that 5 is going to multiply with 2 and 10 is going to multiply with 1. Means row is going to multiply with column. The row is going to multiply with column. That you need to understand. So 5 into 2 plus 10 into 1, that will give the exponential of Ram. And same way for Mohan, 5 is going to multiply with 4 and 10 is going to multiply with 3. Means first I am multiplying first row with first column, then first row with second column. So that's why here 5 2s are 10 and plus 10 into 1, 10. So while matrix multiplication, we multiply the elements and in between them there is a plus sign. Okay, so 5 4s are 20 plus 30, and this way the 10 plus 10 is a 20, 20 plus 30 is a 50, and that is a 1 by 2 matrix, the resultant matrix. So see the students, when matrix multiplication happens, then there is a something that we need to understand ki what is going to be the order of resultant matrix. Means जो result आएगा उसका order क्या होगा. तो resultant of matrix का multiplication number of rows come from first matrix A and number of columns come from the second matrix B. That you can understand from this example only कि in this one the rows that is came from A, one row, and number of column that came from B, that is 2. So this way the matrix multiplication happens. We'll understand more better way in the next slide by considering the one of the first problem of exercise 3.2, where A, B and C are given three matrices. Here we want to find out A plus B, A minus B, 3A minus C, AB and BA. So फटाफट A और B, A plus B निकाल देते हैं. As we say कि addition and subtraction exist when same order is there. So here A and B both are 2 cross 2 matrix, means addition is possible. While finding A plus B, as I said, corresponding elements add होंगे. So 2 is going to add with 1, 2 plus 1, 4 is going to add with 3, 4 plus 3, same way 3 with minus 2, 2 with 5, and therefore the answer is 3, 7, 1, 7. Similarly for A minus B, 2 is going to add with 1, 4 is going to add with 3, subtract, not add, 2 minus 1, 4 minus 3, 3 minus of minus 2, 2 with minus 5, and therefore the result is 1, 1, 5, minus 3. Very easy. And let's see the 3a minus c. How are we going to find the 3a minus c? So first 3 is going to multiply with a, and as I said, scalar multiplication means it is going to multiply with all the elements of A. So that's why the first 3 is going to multiply with 2, 4, 3 and 2. So that's why 3 2s are 6, 3 4s are 12, 3 3s are 9, 3 2s are 6. And as I said, ki subtraction, corresponding elements subtract honge, means 6 is going to get subtract with minus 2, 12 is going to subtract with 5, 9 minus 3, 6 minus 4. And that's why the last result, that is a 8, 7, 6 and 2. Now again, as I said, the most important concept, that is a multiplication. Let's see A into B. So A is a 2, 4, 3, 2. B is a 1, 3, minus 2, 5. Order is a 2 by 2. And matrix multiplication is going to exist because number of column in A, that is a 2. And number of rows in B, that is a 2. Means they are same, that's why it is a possible. And how we are going to multiply? As I said, first row with first column. So 2, 4 is going to multiply with 1 minus 2. Means 2 is going to multiply with 1, 2 into 1. 4 is going to multiply with minus 2. And in between then, addition, plus. So 2 into 1 plus 4 into minus 2. Now first row with second column. Means 2 with 3 plus 4 into 5. Similarly now, second row with first column. Means 3 into 1 plus 2 into minus 2. And now second row with second column, 3 into 3 plus 2 into 5. And that's why if you see the 2 ones are 2, 4 into minus 2 minus 8, 2 threes are 6, 4 fives are 20, 3 ones are 3, 2 into minus 2 minus 4, 9 plus 10, and the last result minus 6, 26 minus 1 and 19. Similarly, let's see the BA. And students, it is not necessary that what is a result of AB, that should be the result of BA. That we'll understand by the next slide. While BA, we write B first and then A. In matrix multiplication, order is very important. Whatever it is a set, you have to write in that order only. It is not like the number multiplication keys, 2 3s are and 3 2s are, both are going to be same. In BA, again, we are going to multiply first row with first column, means 1 3 is going to multiply with 2 3. So 1 into 2. 3 into 3, same way 1 into 4 plus 3 into 2, and similarly second row with first column, second row with second column, and that's why 2 plus 9, 4 plus 6, minus 4 plus 15, minus 8 plus 10, and the result is 11, 10, 11, 2. And if you observe that first slide, AB was minus 6, 26, minus 1, 19, and in this slide, BA is a 11, 10, 11, 2, means matrix multiplication not always give the same result. That's why here the note that matrix multiplication need not be commutative. Sometimes it comes equal, sometimes it may not be. So that's why AB not equal to BA in all the cases, may or may not be. Now it's homework time, exercise 3.2, which is a completely based on the addition, subtraction and multiplication. Easily you can do. Thank you. If you have any doubt, you can WhatsApp me or you can contact me on this number. So be safe at home. Thank you. We'll meet in next video.